Hey guys! So this is another video in this mini-series about some of the patches from the book Patch and Tweak. I will concentrate on the idea of the different patches and develop it using other modules available in VCVREC. If you're not familiar with Patch and Tweak, it's a book all about modular synthesis and the modular environment. There is a link in the description where you can find more information about it, and also the link to where you can find this patch and many others from the book. In this video, we will explore the patch from DivKid, where it uses three different envelopes to control different parameters of a sound. And if you have the book, this patch is on page 98. And as you can see, we have three different envelopes. Let's listen to this also. Oh yeah, very nice. So one envelope is controlling the amplitude of the voice. Another envelope is controlling or modulating the frequency of a low-pass filter. And another one is modulating the pitch of the oscillator through its FM input. Something like this. So let's see how we can develop this patch. First of all, let me just mute it. I will add a clock from JW, which will look like this. Now we will drive the sequencer with this clock. Let's just see that we have more or less the same BPM. Very nice. And what we will do now, we will add some variation in pitch with using a sequential switch, and we will use the one from VCV, which will look like this. I will just put it after the sequencer. Very nice. So we can send up to four different signals to one destination while switching sequentially between those signals. So let's set the other two rows of the sequencer. Let's do something like this. This will be the second row. Very nice. This will be the third one. Okay, very nice. Now let's send the first row to the first two steps of the sequential switch. So we have two steps of the first row, and now another step of row 2 and another step of row 3. Now let's send this to the quantizer, and let's clock the switch with a divided by 8 clock. So we have something like this. Oh yeah, some variation in pitch. Very nice. Now let's add some variation to the envelopes also. And what I will do, I will use sample and hold. I will use the sample and hold module from Bog Audio. In its right click menu, we can choose the range. So we can choose negative, positive, 3 volts. And now for triggering the sample and hold, let's use a logic module, and I will use also the logic module from again Bog Audio. Let's choose two gate outputs from the sequencer. I will go with the first one. I will go with the first one and maybe the fourth. And now out of the XOR output, we will get a gate whenever one gate is high or when the other is high. So eventually we are sort of mixing or combining the gates. And this will trigger the upper sample and hold. And we will use another logic module and combine or mix two other gates. So let's use the third and maybe the last one. And this will trigger the lower sample and hold. Very nice. Now let's use the sample and hold, the upper one, let's say, to modulate the release time of the envelope that controls the filter. This one here. Oh yeah. And let's use the lower one to modulate the release time of the envelope that controls the amplitude of the voice. Oh yes. So we have some movement. Let's add some delay with using ChronoBlob 2 from AllRight Devices. So I will send the voice to Chronoblob. Let's sync Chronoblob with our clock. Set a nice ping pong delay. Take the weight a bit down, a bit less feedback. Let's pan two channels on the mixer left and right. And this will go to the mixer. Maybe change the delay time. Oh yeah. Let's make some space here. Very nice. Okay, let's add another voice, and for this we will use the FM operator from Bog Audio. Let's trigger it with the main clock and activate its built-in level envelope. Set a nice snappy envelope, attack all the way down, sustain all the way down. Now we have to make sure that both oscillators are in tune. So what I will do, I will first set the VCO that we are using from VCV back to defaults by double click to default by double clicking it, which is also pretty nice, but I will want to take it a few octaves lower, so I will use stack again Bog Audio, place it after the quantizer and send the signal first to stack and then to the oscillator. Now here I can take it, let's say, two octaves down. Oh yeah. So now both oscillators should be in tune. So let's use the same pitch information from the quantizer to the FM operator. Let's listen to this also. Oh yeah. Okay, now what we will do now, instead of using three envelopes to change the character of this voice, I will use three sequencers. So let's use three ADDR sequencers. Again, Bog Audio 1, 2, and 3. Let's randomize them. 1, 2, 3. Very nice. Let's set them to different lengths. So let's go here. Okay, let's stay with 5 steps. Let's go here with 7, let's say. And here maybe with 8. Let's set them to have a range of 0 to positive 10 volts. Something like this, and run them with the clock. 1, 2, and 3. Now, one sequencer will control the amplitude of the oscillator. Let me just solo this so we can have a listen. So the first sequencer will modulate the level or the amplitude of the sequence of the oscillator. And let's have some changes here. Something like this, maybe. Oh yeah. Another one will modulate the feedback amount of the oscillator. Oh yes. Now let's add another FM operator. And this FM operator will modulate the frequency of the other FM operator, so it will go to the FM input. Let's change its ratio to 2. So now we have a ratio of 2 to 1, and we will use the same pitch information, so they are in tune somehow. And now the third sequencer will control or modulate the FM depth. So we have even more motion. Of course, let's add some reverb from plateau. Let's take the wet, just a second, all the way down. Send this to the mixer. Bend this left and right. Maybe add some modulation. A bit less decay. Oh yeah. Nice. Okay, so we have a really nice patch that we can develop and build on, and there will be a link of course in the description to this patch, so you can download it and have a closer look. And there's also a link to the whole mini series if you're interested. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you enjoy what I do, consider becoming a patron. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell, and have a good one.